Hey, what's up, fellas? How you doing? Man, Antonelli here.
Okay, so today we're going to look at Babe Ruth's swing. This is a swing that's been going around the internet, Instagram, Twitter, the last week or so. And obviously one of the greatest players to ever play. It's always fun to look back at swings over the years, and so I'm going to play his swing here a couple of times, and then we'll play it in slow motion, and then I want to talk about it, and I'd like your opinion in the comment section below as well. The interesting thing is, because this has been going around the internet and around social media, so many of our players have seen it, and it's been a discussion point lately, and it's interesting. I heard a player or a few players talking about it, and they said, you know, if Babe Ruth played in today's game, he'd never hit, right? And so I heard a couple of players saying that, and then I had to kind of jump in and say, oh, you know, why is that? Why do you feel that, you know, one of the best players to ever play the game wouldn't hit in today's game? And somebody said because his swing, there was too much going on in his swing. There was just too much. He'd be, you know, eaten up by, you know, the stuff and the velocity of today's game. And so it got me thinking about doing a video and talking about some of the things that he did. And so we could go a couple different ways with this. Let's first just kind of look at his overall hitting mechanics. And then we're going to talk about, and I'd like your opinion in the comment section below, what you think about this. But I'm going to give you my thoughts as well about some of the changes that he's probably would have to make and would be forced to make that he wasn't forced to make before because, you know, the pitching that he was facing didn't call for him to make any changes. And so let's start with this. The biggest thing, when you watch, really almost any hitter, in my opinion, independent of the era that they play, they all have very similar, we call them core principles, right? And so you're going to see a lot of the core principles consistent no matter the era that you watch. The style in which they do it, maybe the degree in which they do it, is a little bit different, all right? And so the biggest thing I think when you watch Babe Ruth get ready to hit, a couple things. One, you see the feet really close together, right? So you see this, you see a bigger move. And really, it's not just with the stride and the feet close together, but it's really with everything, right? It's a bigger stride. It's a barrel that really starts to get tipped forward. So you see this a lot during this era where you see the barrel start to kind of tip towards the opposite batter's box, like really tip away from him right here, right? So as he starts to make this little bit of a coil move, right? So again, consistent, we talk about getting the back pocket turned this way so the hips close and coil that way and so the back leg can load back. And so you see that move right here. But what you see is you see a more of an exaggerated stride or forward move, right? And his feet are right next to each other. So of course, they have to make an exaggerated move. So you start to see that coil. You start to see the move where the weight starts to move out here, a little bit more, again, exaggerated. You see the bigger stride, and you see it timing up with this really, really big bat tip, right? And so this is a move that, from what, you know, talking to our players, younger players, and I've heard people say this, that, you know, these type of moves, this would never work. Like, he could never do this in today's game. Well, here's my thought on this. And we've seen players, we've seen guys that have bat pumps like a David Ortiz or a Barry Bonds, right? We've seen different players do different things with their hands and with the bat to get the bat ready to hit. And again, what you see more towards this era was this really kind of big bat tip forward. So not so much the bat tip this way, which you see now. You see guys like Javi Baez. You see a lot of big leaguers kind of tip the bat that way. And we just talked about guys that would kind of pump their hands down like an Ortiz or a Barry Bonds. But you'd see this move. And so in my opinion, the reason why you see bigger moves, this bigger move back then, is because the guy was basically using a log as a bat. I believe he used a 40 plus ounce bat. I've seen as high as 42 ounces. And so in order to get a 42 ounce bat into the zone on time, you need to get a little bit of a cheat. You need to get a little bit of a running start with that barrel. And so you see a lot of players that would start to kind of tip the barrel, get the barrel moving. So now it basically makes the weight of the barrel much less. And so once I get it in motion, now I can use that motion to be able to get back into a hitting position. But again, it's like getting a little bit of a running start. It's like if we were going to race each other, right? If we're going to race each other, are you going to be quicker if we just say go and you have to take off from this starting point right here? Or if I can let someone start 5 feet behind that line, let them get a head start and then start the timer when they get to that this yellow line right here. Of course, you're going to run faster if I let you start here and get a running start versus someone that has to stand still, right? And so this is basically his running start. It's getting the barrel moving because he has such a big, huge, heavy bat. If he were just to get into this position, right? And when you think about swings from today, and again, everyone's unique, but you'll see more players that have much less movement, right? And so the lows are kind of quieter, typically a little bit smaller strides. You're not going to see a barrel moving as much again, although you will still see it with some players. But you're also talking about players that are using lighter bats. You're talking about even bigger and stronger, more explosive athletes. And so you're also talking about players that do have to hit 95 to 100 mile an hour fastballs with nasty breaking stuff, 90 plus mile an hour sliders. The pitching is unbelievable now. And so you're not going to see as many players hit like this anymore. But you also, like I said, don't need to because the barrel and the bat is not as heavy. So that's one really big thing that stands out to me, right? If we continue to make this move, though, as we start to see this little bit of a lean, a little bit of a coil, now we've got the stride, we've got the tip of the bat going forward and then coming back. When we get to this point right here, if we get rid of that running start, he is essentially going to do the same thing that every elite hitter does, right? And so you're going to see that back leg starting to turn as his front foot is about to come into the ground, right? You see the barrel starting to work back this way, right? So you see the barrel getting turned back. So you've got a leg, back leg, lower half turning that way. You see everything else in the upper half going back this way. The barrel is turning back there. So you create that stretch, that separation. Now as his leg continues to turn, I know it's a little bit of a tougher angle to see from back here, but you can see the barrel working slightly up through the ball. You can see the lead arm working up. He's palm up through the ball. So now all of a sudden we have the exact same core principles happening. Just the style in which it happens is a little bit different, taking into account things like the pitching that he's facing, the equipment that he's using. He just needs bigger moves because the bat's heavier. And again, the pitching isn't the same type of pitching that he's going to face if he were to play today. So every move that he makes is a little bit more exaggerated, again, than in present time. Now, anyone that says, oh, Babe Ruth could never hit in today's game, maybe he wouldn't hit as well using these exact mechanics. But there is no doubt that he would make a couple of small, subtle changes. He wouldn't be swinging a 42-ounce bat, right? And so it's really difficult to be able to compare also when you look mechanically at players from different generations because the game has changed so much. And so what he was able to do offensively with his swing, the way his body was able to move, was exactly what was needed to be one of the greatest hitters to ever play the game, really of all time, but especially to be successful during the time that he played. So really, really cool stuff. It's always interesting to find video of players, like I said, especially players that are all-time greats. But this is the really interesting move for me, the thing that stands out that I show no matter who the player is, right? That back leg starting to turn and the barrel starting to work back, right? That barrel getting turned back in proper sequence, and now all of a sudden, boom, the barrel's delivered to the ball. So it doesn't get much prettier than that. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. What else stands out to you watching Babe swing or other swings of that time? And let me know if you're somebody that thinks Babe Ruth wouldn't be able to hit if you put him in a game today. Again, I think you give him a couple of at-bats. Maybe give him a bat that doesn't weigh 45 pounds. And the dude's going to rake. That's all we got. Let me know what you think. Subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell, give it a thumbs up, all that good stuff. We'll talk to you later.
If you've got hitters that you're looking to improve before the start of next season, this is essential for you. Matt Antonelli here, former major league player, first round pick, and college coach. With this course, we're going to show you exactly, step by step, how to generate power, develop bat speed, and enhance swing mechanics. Regardless of your hitter's age, this course is going to deliver advanced hitting techniques that will allow any hitter to get better and make an impact at the plate this spring. We have a full catalog of training content that you can access from anywhere at any time. This course is perfect for players, parents, coaches, instructors, and more. It offers a comprehensive package of drills and techniques that you can directly implement. Our course has helped hitters all over the country at different competition levels, and the feedback that we've received has been outstanding. The work you put in now will drive your success at the plate this spring. Get the essential knowledge that you need to take your game to the next level. I've put the link in the description if you want to go check it out.